Imagine waking up one day and feeling very sick. You cannot hear, your vision is blurry, your balance is off, and your words are very slurred. Nothing like it used to be. Now imagine this happening to a celebrity like Ashton Kutcher. Was he drinking too much? Was he too tired?
I woke up one day and was having vision issues, could hardly see, knocked out my hearing, which threw off my equilibrium, my balance, and I couldn't walk. And
thanks God, his wife was with him and she realized that something is wrong and she took him to the hospital where they diagnosed him with a rare autoimmune disease that we call vasculitis.
You don't really appreciate it until it's gone, until you go, I don't know if I'm ever gonna be able to see again. I don't know if I'm ever gonna be able to hear again. I don't know if I'm ever gonna be able to walk again.
Wow, what an ordeal.
But the real question is, could this happen to you? I am Dr. Diana Girnita, and in this video, I decided to share my 15 years of experience treating complex autoimmune diseases, including vasculitis, and we will discuss what is vasculitis, what are the most common signs that you should never ignore, and how to treat them, and is this a life-threatening disease?
Talk about strength through adversity.
Lucky to be alive.
Lucky to be alive.
When you heard Ashton Kutcher's symptoms, I am sure that many of you thought it must be so scary to be a healthy, a celebrity, and one day your life is upside down. And it is dramatic, because probably when they told him that he suffered with vasculitis, he had the same questions.
There's a standard you become accustomed to in your life, like, and then suddenly you can't see, like you have this like occlusion. Like, why are you not talking louder? Because I can't hear you. You want to reclaim the health that you once had.
What is vasculitis? Now let's analyze the word. Vasculitis comes from vessels, which is that network of blood supply that brings the oxygen and feeds your organs. And itis means inflammation. So vasculitis is an inflammation of the blood vessels. Now, this inflammation of the blood vessel will restrict the blood flow to the organs, to the tissue. It will also damage the blood vessels. It will make them weak. It will make them prone to rupture, and that will make the disease life-threatening. Now, there are many symptoms that you can develop with vasculitis, and they depend on the type of blood vessels that is affected. For example, if your big blood vessels in the brain are affected, then you're gonna end up with headaches or stroke-like symptoms. But if you have small vessels affected like capillaries, then you will have symptoms like bleeding under the skin, which can cause some types of rashes. But what causes vasculitis and why did it happen to Ashton Kutcher? As I mentioned, vasculitis is an autoimmune disease, which means that your immune system will mistakenly attack your healthy blood vessels. While we don't know exactly what's the trigger, there are some common causes that we know about. For example, infections. Some bacterial or viral infections can trigger your immune system, which can lead to vasculitis. Another cause are other autoimmune diseases. Conditions like lupus, like rheumatoid arthritis, or even Sjogren's disease will increase the risk to develop vasculitis. Another cause are medications, like certain antibiotics, certain blood pressure medications, or anti-seizure drugs. They were also linked to vasculitis. In some cases, even genetics. There are some types of vasculitis that tend to run in families. For example, if you are of Scandinavian descent, you will have a higher risk to develop giant cell arteritis, which is a vasculitis that affects the brain vessels. And sometimes even environmental factors like smoking, toxins, and even the extreme stress can contribute to this autoimmune disease that we call vasculitis. Now, you're gonna ask me, what saved Ashton's life? His life was actually saved by recognizing the early signs before the severe damage was done.
But quote, I fully recovered, all good, moving on. And the actor, who plans to run the 2022 New York City Marathon in November, seemed to be in great spirits on Monday night when he stepped out for a charity event at Dodger Stadium in Los Angeles with his wife, Mila Kunis.
Let's learn a little bit more about the common signs of vasculitis. As I mentioned, patients with vasculitis vasculitis can have many symptoms, and that again will depend on the type of blood vessels that is affected. But the most common warning signs include severe fatigue, weakness, low-grade fevers, unexplained weight loss, some skin rashes or some purplish spots. Some patients will develop joint pain or muscle aches. Some patients will develop headaches or dizziness or stroke-like symptoms. They can also develop vision issues like blurriness or even sudden loss of the vision. There are patients that will develop hearing loss or ringing in the ears. There are also patients that will develop numbness or tingling in the hands, in the feet, and sometimes foot drop or wrist drop symptoms. There are also patients that will develop sinus issues that will never go away. They come and go, then they need to be treated again and again. There are patients that will develop blood in the lungs and they will have shortness of breath, or they will develop symptoms that they look like a severe pneumonia, but there is no infection there. There are also patients that will develop severe abdominal pain or blood in the stool or blood in the urine. But all of this needs to be judged by someone that knows what vasculitis is. Now let's go back to Ashton's case. His eyes, his ears, and his balance were affected, which suggests that he probably had a vasculitis that affected his brain vessels. Now, before this video, have you heard about vasculitis? Please leave me a comment and let me know what you know about vasculitis, and if you know someone that was diagnosed, or even what symptoms have you had with this disease. How can we treat vasculitis, and what happens if you ignore it? The good news is that vasculitis is treatable, and many times with great results, but early intervention is key. How can we choose the treatment depends on the severity of the disease and which organs were involved. But some of the most common treatments will include corticosteroids, like prednisone, and they need to be used immediately after the diagnosis because they will help reduce the inflammation quickly. We also use immunosuppressive drugs like methotrexate or azathioprine that can help control the immune system. And in more severe cases, we use rituximab or we use cyclophosphamide, which is a more targeted type of medication that will block certain parts of the immune system. In even more complicated cases, we use plasma exchange. And this is used when you have the lungs affected or the kidneys affected. And this is a type of treatment that will filtrate your blood through a very sophisticated machine. And in this way, we will be able to remove the antibodies that we think are the ones who are targeting your inner organs. What happens if you ignore it? Please do not. This is a life-threatening disease. Ignoring vasculitis can lead to permanent damage of your organs, could lead to strokes, to heart disease, to lung disease, and even kidney failure. Without the treatment, without the appropriate treatment or treatment given in time, there are people that die because of this form of autoimmune disease that we call vasculitis. And that is why, if you were once completely healthy, but now you have all of a sudden developed unexplained symptoms like this severe fatigue, the vision loss, the joint pain, the skin rashes, and all the other symptoms that I mentioned, do not ignore them. Vasculitis can develop at any age, and getting evaluated early can make all the difference. And now that you have learned about vasculitis, about how vasculitis changed Ashton Kutcher's lives, learn about how another celebrity, Venus Williams, battled a disease that is very commonly misdiagnosed. And it took her 7 years to get to a diagnosis. So, do you want to hear her story?